DKB, par exemple, I'm Togolese and I'm in MSc Mathematics at Epi Goel Shimla University in the North India. This is a good university in North India. And today, I want to prove Cauchy's theorem for abelian group because this theorem is very good. I will give you the statement of this theorem. This theorem says that. Statement of this theorem. This theorem says that if G is a finite abelian group, if G is a finite abelian group and P is a prime such that P divide order of G, then G has an element of order P. An element of order P. Order P. If G is a finite abelian group and P is a prime such that P divide order of G, then G has an element of order P. Proof. We shall prove by induction. We shall prove by induction. By induction. Firstly, let order of G is equal to 1. Then we know there is no prime which order there is no prime which order there is no prime which divide order of G. There is no prime which divide order of G. If it is that, the theorem is true. The theorem is true since it is impossible to get a counter-example. Theorem is true since it is impossible to get a counter-example. If has no proper subgroup, then J is cyclic. Then G is cyclic. Therefore, all elements A not equal to identity will be generator of G will be generator of G since P divide order of G, therefore order of G is equal to P. Also, every group of prime order is cyclic. It is for that all elements of G will be generator of G. Thus, G has P minus 1 element A is not equal to identity such that a to the power p equal to a to the power of order of g is equal to e by definition of order. Next, let H be a proper subgroup of G. It means H is not equal to identity and H is not equal to G. If P divide order of H, then by our induction hypothesis, the theorem is true. The theorem is true because H is an abelian group. An abelian group. And order of H is less than order of G because A is a subgroup of G. The theorem is true for H. The theorem is true for H. Theorem is true for H. Then, therefore, there exists an element B belongs H. B is not equal to identity such that B to the power P is equal to identity. But B belongs H implies that B belongs G because H is a subgroup of G. Thus, there exists an element B belongs G. B is not equal to identity such that B to the power P is equal to identity. Then, let P does not divide order of H. Since order of G is equal to order of G by H times order of H and P divide order of G. We get what? P divide order of G by H times order of H. But we know P does not divide order of H. It implies that P divide order of G by H. Also, order of G by H is less than order of G as H is not equal to identity. But G is abelian and H is a subgroup. H is a subgroup of G. H is a subgroup of J. We know that every subgroup of an abelian. Every subgroup, an abelian group is what is normal. Is normal. Which implies that G by H is a quotient group. Is a quotient group. Quotient group. So, by induction hypothesis, G by H as an element HC of order P. Of order P. Therefore, HC to the power P is equal to H by definition of order, which implies that HC P is equal to H. Why? Because H to the power P is equal to H, which implies that C to the power P belongs H. Implies that CP all to the power n is equal to identity where m is equal to order of h. Implies C to the power m all to the power p is equal to identity, which implies that order of CM divide order of p. Then all implies order of CM is equal to 1 or P because P is prime. Firstly, if order of CM is equal to 1, we have C to the power M equal to identity. Then HCM is equal to HE is equal to A. Implies HC all to the power M is equal to H. Implies order of HC divide M implies P divide M, but M is equal to order of H. All implies P divide order of H, which is a contradiction. Which is a contradiction because we suppose that P does not divide order of H. Therefore, order of CM is equal to P. CM belongs G. So the result is true in this case. The result is true in this case. Then, by induction, the result is true. Is true for all abelian group. All abelian group. Then, I think you know that Cauchy's theorem for abelian group. It is my given for this demonstration. After I will prove a second theorem or the first, second, and third silo theorem. We have silo first theorem, silo second theorem, and silo third theorem. I will prove after this theorem too. Thank you and very much. Good journey.